All right, so I'm here with Nate. Nate, tell me, for those that don't know you, just tell me a little bit about yourself.
Sure. Hey everyone, my name's Nate. I'm from Connecticut, and I've been practicing for approximately 16 years. I have a private practice up there, and I've been teaching the last year, teaching myoskeletal alignment technique in the New England area, teaching the great work of Eric Dalton.
Nate's fantastic. I've been talking to him this weekend, but anyway, Nate, I wanted to talk to you about the experience of an Eric Dalton weekend. So tell me, what has impressed you the most over this weekend so far?
Yeah, I think what continues to impress me by coming to study with Eric used to use a line, standing on the shoulders of giants. And that's how I feel this weekend, being around great guys like Eric Dalton, Art Riggs, and many other guest presenters that are here. It's amazing watching Eric in his over 30 plus years of wisdom, being on stage, having the energy of a 30-year-old, and his passion for body work. I always say every time I come and take a class with Eric or be a teaching assistant for Eric, my candle stays lit seeing guys like him that are just continually passionate about this work.
God, you know, and everyone I talk to has the same kind of passion, especially the master myoskeletal therapist.
Yeah.
And so I have to ask this question. If, you know, if you were to talk to somebody that was kind of on the fence about, you know, should I go to an Eric Dalton workshop? What would you tell them? What would you tell them to get them to come to a workshop?
You know, I use the Nike tagline, just do it, right? So I think sometimes I feel like people might be overwhelmed because they hear that there's a lot of people. There's 100 people, there's 200 people. But with a 200 person class atmosphere, it's so intimate. I mean, we have approximately 16 TAs work in the room. Even Eric is standing on stage watching people, making sure that they're getting it. And I felt the same way, you know, back in 2007 when I, you know, was learning about Eric, I was really intimidated to go to a workshop. And I'll tell you, man, I let too many years of my career going by before I did it. And I was like, oh, this is what I've been missing out on.
I love that. Just do it. And you're not gonna take everything home with you. You're gonna take a little bit.
Yeah.
So tell me, what are you gonna take home from this experience this weekend?
What am I gonna take home? I'm gonna take home that my candle's gonna continue to burn. That I want to be, I want to be 70 in my 70s, just like Eric, still seeing clients a week. Those are one of my biggest take homes. And now that I'm actually, you know, now that I've been teaching, you know, I've actually taken some things that I've Eric's teaching style. I've watched a little bit closer this weekend. It's been 2 years since we've been in a workshop since the pandemic, so I'm taking some of how he's some of his presentations and some of his words so that I can become a better teacher for you guys.
Yeah. That's fantastic.
Yeah.
So tell me, is there anything in particular that stands out for you this weekend?
Oh man, like from a technique standpoint or a...
Man, personal, just fun, anything.
Yeah, you know what? I just swallowed my coffee wrong. I think, honestly, man, I think after not seeing people for 2 years, I think that's the biggest thing to me because we are I'm not crying, by the way, it's the coffee. It's in my throat.
He's not crying.
But you know, we are a touch-based community, and that's what we do for our clients. You know, and I say that to my students too. You know, no matter the fanciest technique you have, the coolest assessment that you have, we are ultimately giving people compassionate touch. And to be in a room with 200 therapists this weekend and exchanging those basic ideas, that's what it's all about.
That's so true, man. Yeah. It's well said.
Thank you.
I'm gonna wipe the tears.
Wipe the tears, man.
Thanks for taking a couple minutes to talk to me. Is there anything that I didn't ask you that you wanted to share with the one or two people that may be watching?
No, man. Hey, if you're in Ben's area, go check this guy out, because you all are lucky. So that's what I have to say.
Thanks, Nate.
All right, man. Thank you.